This is Prime Boy, Prime Boy's Angling Adventures. After a very long walk, I am on my probably second wading trip of the year. I'm going to be going for multi-species. It's 8 o'clock, which looks really early right here, but it's almost 8. It's a really late start for me. So I'm going to be looking for anything dark like this, dark pools, and I'm going to be throwing either minnows or crawlers and see what I can find in these pools. There we go, first fish. Like I said, I'm just here to breathe, take in the beauty, and catch some pretty fish. I'm not concerned today what size or numbers. Just happy to be here. There's one. Oh, a little smallie. What I use when I'm doing this is just a 6'6 light action rod. It's just long enough to fend off a big catfish or a carp, but you can land a big, nice smallmouth. You can have lots of fun with these little guys because the tip is so bendy, but you have the length, so it makes a lot of fun. The beauty of this is if you're not an I have to have bass guy, anything that'll hit a minnow, leech, or crawler, we'll hit this stuff. So if you have white bass, yellow bass, crappie, walleye, catfish, carp, suckers, bluegills, sunfish of any kind, northern pike, muskie, and you're rotating, you know, crawlers, minnows, I wish I had leeches today, but they're just out of season. You can catch basically anything that's in a particular river. Now this one has mostly smallmouth, small channel catch, suckers, carp, an occasional crappie, sunfish, lots of smallmouth, and then usually each trip I'll get one good chance at a couple big ones. What's cool though, I like about this is it's just so pretty and so clear, and in Illinois we just don't have a lot of this. You'll be able to see the fish fighting underwater, you know, and you walk up this path and all of a sudden it's like you're in a different state. It's pretty amazing. You're gonna lose a lot of hooks, you're gonna lose some floats, especially when you're throwing around timber all morning. And I'll just drift a hole over and over again. I'll dissect every little inch of it, and then once they stop biting I move to the next hole. Problem with these little creeks is the rains change it every year. So a hole I was really looking forward to fishing this year isn't there. This tree obviously fell, created a new hole. It's not the biggest, it's a short hole. So trying to get in there, it's only got a few good feet to fish. So I caught two out of here. I saw one other little one. And I'll rotate each hole with crawlers and minnows, and if I had leeches, I'd do all three. And once I've gone through all three and picked out every species of fish or fish that's willing to bite, there's one. I missed it. Fish that's willing to bite, then I move on. There we go. Thank you, little friend. Let me go over what I'm using. So you want a small spring quality balsa float or steelhead float. In this case, I'm using Raven, and it has these rubber pieces. Helps me slide it up and down so I can change the depth. And I have a shotting pattern, and this holds the bait down nice and slow. And then in this case, it's a Raven Specialist hook, but any number 4 or 6 octopus hook will do. Not very deep. Oh, largemouth. There we go. This would be my first decent fish, well, compared to the little dinks we had. This guy's fighting. So see the rod, you can hold it sideways, you can kind of steer him. This isn't huge, but it's better than what we had before. Probably was living under that log, yeah. There's okay smallie. So you have fun with the little ones until you find a nice fun one like this one. It's not gigantic by no means, but it's a nice fun fish to play. Hit it. There we go. Largemouth. There we go. Fish of the day. Yay! Alright. So, that's why I come here. Relaxing, pretty, and occasionally a really nice smallmouth.